You know, guys, if there's one thing about the EFF, man, these people, they know how to make my day. I could be having the worst day of my life, and I would see one report about the EFF, then the whole day changes. Suddenly, I'm a happy man. These people, man, since yesterday till now, as we speak, they've been having an epic meltdown after some of their disgruntled members joined the African National Congress yesterday. You know, not so long ago, the EFF publicly expelled some of their members for failing to organize the buses for their 10-year anniversary event at FNB Stadium. EFF kicked those people out of the party publicly. So it's a matter of fact right now that we have disgruntled EFF supporters or disgruntled EFF members. So yesterday, the African National Congress was at West Rand in Wedela Hall. And in that event, the African National Congress welcomed some of these disgruntled members to the African National Congress, these people who come from the Economic Freedom Fighters. So I made this video specifically because I'm looking at the reaction from the EFF. And I'm looking from the reaction from the people in general. And I'm like, man, this has to be some bogus nonsense. Because what the EFF is saying is that there is no way that the EFF members can go from EFF to joining the African National Congress. That is their claim. That this whole thing, all of these people are bought. ANC paid these people to come forward wearing the EFF jerseys and taking them off and wearing the ANC supporters. They say these people are bought. So what I don't understand about this whole thing is that for years we've seen people leave in different parties and joining other parties. But because these people are popular, it is okay for us to say, okay, fine, Bongani Baloyi left the DA and went to join Action SA. Yeah, it's fine, Bongani Baloyi can do that. It is fine for us to say that Bongani Baloyi left Action SA. Like, it is okay for us to say these people have left these certain parties and joined these political parties, and people immediately believe that these people did that. But when it comes to average South Africans, now it's a problem. Because how can you say that these people are bored? Because you can't tell me that every single person that is the member of the EFF is happy with the EFF. Right now, you have people that are not happy with African National Congress. People have been leaving the African National Congress for years. The Democratic Alliance knows this too. People have been leaving the Democratic Alliance and joining different political parties. They know this too. But because these people who are leaving these parties are popular, people have no problem with that. But now that it's average South Africans leaving EFF and going to the African National Congress, now it's a problem. These people are paid. And you can't tell me that these people are paid. How can you say these people are paid? Because one thing for sure is that these people who are taking out their EFF jerseys and wearing the ANC jerseys, no one knows who these people are. So the first thing that you say is that these people are paid. So are you honestly telling me that South Africans right now, they cannot leave the EFF and join the African National Congress on their own will? How is it possible for people to go from the African National Congress and joining the EFF, from people going to from the DA and joining Action SA, from the people from going to the ANC, from joining other political parties? But for some reason, it is impossible for people to go from the EFF to join the African National Congress. And I'm sitting back and I'm like, whoa, this is strictly some political immaturity nonsense. Because these things happen just because most of the time when it happens with popular people and it's all over the news and we immediately believe it. It doesn't mean that it happens with average South Africans. Average South Africans also have the right to say that, okay, right now, I don't think the EFF is working for me, so I'm going to join the African National Congress. Or the EFF has done 1, 2, 3 for me. So for me to pay revenge, after all, this is politics. After all, this is politics. From someone to say that, okay, the EFF has done something for me and I am hurt about what the EFF has done for me, I am going to join the African National Congress. And for people to simply say that, oh, that person is bored. I mean, come on, guys. What kind of reasoning is this? These people have been having an epic meltdown from yesterday till now. And I don't know, why are you people having an epic meltdown? People have been leaving political parties and joining political parties for years. Why are you guys so hurt about the fact that the people left the EFF and went to join the African National Congress? And why are you saying, the first thing, why are you saying these people are bored? This is classism, man. It's classism. For you to say that the first thing for you to say that these people are bored just because these people are average South Africans. It is classism. It is classism. Right here, guys, I'm going to show you a video that exactly demonstrates how the EFF feels about this whole thing of their members leaving the EFF and joining the African National Congress. I want you to hear how the EFF reasons around this whole thing.
Hello there, guys, and welcome to Daily Update. It's Sunday, and we are seeing a very embarrassing moment from the ANC, from the Secretary General of the ANC, Mr. Fikile Mbalula. One wonders who really signed on the idea of Fikile Mbalula saying that today is Sunday, we are welcoming the members of the EFF into the ANC. Who really signed, who co-signed that idea that whatever that you are coming up with, Fikile, is one of the best ideas? Because in turn, he got embarrassed. Nicely, thanks to EWN placing that camera there, where we can see that those people were given t-shirts. They change from their clothes into the t-shirts of EFF. They go straight into the hall where Fikile Mbalula is welcoming them into the EFF. If it's not a party that ran out of ideas, if it's not a party...
Guys, to stay on that thing that these people were given the t-shirts outside of the venue, to go inside the venue to take these t-shirts out, to wear African National Congress t-shirts. Guys, this is politics. This is politics. These people left the EFF. Are you honestly telling me that you expect people who are no longer the members of the EFF to go to an ANC event wearing the EFF jerseys only for them to take out those jerseys at the event for them to wear the African National Congress jerseys? There is nothing wrong with the African National Congress buying these jerseys, buying these EFF jerseys for these people to wear so that these people can take these jerseys out and wear African National Congress jerseys. Guys, this is politics. It is always about the statement. It is always about the statement. So this whole thing that EWN exposed the ANC because they placed a camera there and that camera showed these people being given the EFF t-shirts only for them to go inside the hall to take out these EFF t-shirts to wear ANC t-shirts. Guys, this is politics. You can't tell me that you expect these people to leave their houses wearing EFF t-shirts. Why would these people wear EFF t-shirts? If I'm a disgruntled EFF member, I wanted to join the African National Congress. The African National Congress is having an event where they say, okay, we are going to welcome you to the African National Congress. Why the hell would I go to that event wearing an EFF t-shirt? I am no longer the member of the EFF. I can wear the jersey at the event only for me to take it out, to show the people that I'm taking this jersey out and I'm wearing the African National Congress jersey. So this whole thing that the EWN exposed ANC, it didn't expose the ANC. This is politics. This is a statement. You can't expect these people to leave their homes wearing the EFF jerseys. These people are no longer the members of the EFF. So why do you expect these people to still have the EFF jerseys or to still have the EFF t-shirts? Why? This is politics, man. I mean, like, even me, let's say I'm a member of the Democratic Alliance and I'm leaving the Democratic Alliance to go and join Action SA. I'm not going to leave my house wearing a t-shirt of the Democratic Alliance. Why the hell would I wear a t-shirt of the Democratic Alliance when I'm no longer the member of the Democratic Alliance? The Democratic Alliance kicked me out. I'm no longer the member of the party. Why would I leave my home wearing a t-shirt of the Democratic Alliance? You know what I can do? I can go to the event, and when I get to the event, I can wear a t-shirt of the Democratic Alliance only for me to take it out in front of cameras and wear the t-shirt of the African National Congress. This is politics. This is statements. Just because this camera was there watching these people, it doesn't mean that these people were not the members of the EFF. The fact remains, these people were the members of the EFF. Whether these people were given the t-shirts outside the venue, it doesn't matter. You cannot expect these people to come from their homes wearing the EFF t-shirts when they're no longer the members of the EFF. It makes no sense. It makes sense for these people to go to the event and wear the EFF t-shirts only for them to take them out and wear the ANC t-shirts. It makes sense. This is politics. This is about statements. You can't tell me just because these people didn't leave their homes wearing the EFF t-shirts, these are not real EFF supporters. These people are bored. These people are bored. Why are you people so quickly to say that people are being bored when they make their own decisions? You can't stand to see people make their own decisions, especially against the EFF. This is the problem with the EFF. They can't stand watching other people making their own decisions, especially against the EFF. Just because these people are average South Africans, just because these people are not popular, it doesn't mean that they are bought. These people, they still have their right to say that I no longer want to be the member of the EFF. I now want to be the member of the African National Congress. It doesn't matter whether these people are popular or not. You people only want to accept this move when it's been done by people who are popular. But when it's done by average South Africans, majority of the people in this country are average South Africans. Most of us, we are simply average South Africans. We are not the elite. We are average South Africans. So why is it a problem when you see an average South African leaving the EFF and going to the African National Congress? Why is the first thing you say is that these people are bought? Who bought these people? Who bought them? You don't even have a proof that these people are bought. And your only evidence is saying that now there was a camera outside watching these people being given the EFF t-shirts, and these people went inside the hall and took the EFF t-shirts out and wore the ANC t-shirts. Man, this is politics. This is statements. You cannot expect people to leave their homes wearing the EFF t-shirts when they no longer hate the EFF, when they no longer love the EFF. This is politics.
That knows that the death is near, then we don't know. Because why would you go so low if you really know that you have everything under control in 2020? Why would you go so low?
Guys, why is this matter considered going low? Why is average South Africans joining the EFF, joining the ANC is considered a low? It is not a low. Why are you calling it low? You're calling it low because these people are not popular. So you are a classist, basically. You are telling us that this is low for the ANC to do. But at the end of the day, political parties are supposed to serve average South Africans. At the end of the day, these people that you call low are the people that are supposed to be served by political parties. Political parties are looking for their support from these people that the EFF is calling low. Why are you calling these people low? There's nothing low about these people. Man, I am not the advocate from the African National Congress. You know, most of the time, I disagree with African National Congress. I am strict when it comes to the African National Congress. Man, I criticize these people each and every day. But when these things happen, man, I look at these things from a perspective of an average South African. Man, I don't care about political parties. I don't care about the ANC. I don't care about the EFF. I don't care about the DA. I don't care about political parties. I care about the people of this country. And these people, man, they still have their right to make their own choices. For you to say that this is a low thing because these people are not popular, it shows you that you are a classist. You can only accept this move if it's done by someone popular. If it's done by someone, by an average South African, someone like you, you consider it a low. It is not low. These are average South Africans. Guys, we can say whatever that we want. You can say whatever that you want to say about the African National Congress. You can say whatever that you want about the EFF. You can say whatever that you want about the DA. But at the end of the day, people still have their right to choose which political parties to join. It is not for us to say these people are not supposed to join certain political parties. It's for certain political parties to convince people to join their parties. At the end of the day, average South Africans still have their right to join the political parties they want. So for people to say that this is low, how is it low when average South Africans are making their own decisions? This is not about the EFF. This is not about the ANC. Right now, when I'm speaking about this, this is not about ANC. It is not about the EFF. It is about average South Africans and making their own decisions. Why is it a problem when you see average South Africans making their own decisions? They make their own decisions. Why is it a problem?
To even organize by people, organize people. Get them, give them t-shirts. If really I'm a member of a party and then I come to you saying that I'm joining you, I don't even have a t-shirt. I don't even have anything to show to you that I was a member of that party. Then you organize t-shirts for me.
Man, why would these people still have the EFF material? They are no longer the members of the EFF. Why do these people must have documents, t-shirts, something to show that they were members of the EFF? They are no longer the members of the EFF. They don't care about the material of the EFF. If someone says, no, man, I was the member of the EFF, I no longer want to be the member of the EFF. Now I want to be the member of the ANC. Why should the ANC say, no, you must show us your form, show us your t-shirts, show us your pictures that you were the member of the EFF? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter whether these people still have material in their own hands. They don't need to have material in their own hands. These people, if they say we were the members of the EFF, they were the members of the EFF. None of us can say these people, no, they were not the members of the EFF. Why are people so convinced that these people were not the members of the EFF? I'm saying these people, the chances are these people could be the members of the EFF. So for you to require these people to have some material to show this African National Congress that, okay, this is what I can show you, that I was the member of the EFF. Why should people do that? People, they don't need to do that. The only thing these people have is their own choice. They can make their own choices. Why is it so hard for the EFF to see other people making their own choices? Guys, I didn't want to be mad, man, at this video. I didn't want to be mad. But this kind of rhetoric, man, it is one rhetoric that really frustrates me. Because we protect politicians so much to the point that we even look down on our own people. We protect politicians, we protect political parties so much that we even willing to look down on our own people. You know, man, if I see people leaving a certain political party or joining other political party, I could have my own opinions. I could say, man, that is a stupid move for these people to go and from the DA and join the Action SA. That was a stupid move from people from Action SA to join. Man, I could have my own opinions about what people do. But that doesn't mean that I can make those choices for those people. At the end of the day, people still have their own right to make their own choices. So for us to have our own opinions. We can have our own opinions, but we cannot impose our own opinions on these people. At the end of the day, guys, we are average South Africans. We cannot look down on our own people because we want to protect political parties so much. People are laughing at these people. People are calling these people nobodies. People are calling these people useless and all sorts of names just because these people are average South Africans. So is it okay for you guys to call these people low, to call these people to laugh, to call these people all of sorts of names because these people are not popular? Do you think it's okay for you guys to do that? And why do you guys think it's okay only for popular people to make their own decisions and say, I no longer want to be the member of this party, I want to join a certain party? Why do you think it's okay for only popular people to make their choice? Why is it not okay for average South Africans to make those choices? The ANC was at that event because they wanted to speak to average South Africans. If the ANC wanted to speak to the elite, they could have went to Sandton Convention Center and did the event there, because you know at those Sandton Convention Center you have to buy the seats. They could have done that if they wanted to speak with the elite, but they went to the people. So these are the people that ANC was looking to engage. So why are you calling this move low? How is this move low when average South Africans are the ones making their own decisions? We cannot protect the political parties, guys, to this extent. You can love your own political party that you want, but you cannot defend it to this extent. At the end of the day, we are still people. We still have the room to make our own decisions. Every day we talk about the supporters of the African National Congress. Every day we talk about the supporters of the African National Congress and the fact that these people are the ones who are hurting this country right now. And it's sad that at this point, the majority of the voters are still the voters who want to vote for the African National Congress. We talk about these people each and every day. But we will never say these people must not vote for the African National Congress. We will never do that. Because at the end of the day, these people can make their own decisions. They can make their own choices. If someone wants to listen to me and says, after I've watched that video from Thomas, I no longer want to be the member of the African National Congress, then kudos, you also made your own decision. We can't make decisions on people's behalf. And we cannot be out here on social media crying and whining. Because if this one thing that shows me about this whole thing that happened yesterday is that the EFF, most of these supporters, man, they are immature. It's political immaturity. Because if you understood politics, this is politics. Politics is about statements. It is just politics. And for you to expect these people to walk around with their EFF t-shirts only to prove that they were members of the EFF, it is stupid. For you to say this move is stupid, man, you are stupid.
To show that I was the member of that party, then... Well, you bought me. You are really buying my vote. You are really buying my face to be able to demonstrate that, well, I'm doing whatever you are telling me so that the ratings can go up. But he's killing the ratings of the ANC. And
how are you killing the ratings of the ANC when you are working with the people on the ground? How is any political party killing its own ratings when they are working with the people on the ground? He says this move is killing the ratings of the ANC. What ratings? What ratings? It's killing the ratings of the ANC. What ratings? So working with average South Africans is killing the ratings. welcoming Afro South Africans from an opposition political parties is killing the ratings. This is superior logic. This is EFF's superior logic. Working with the people on the ground. Welcoming people on the ground who are the members of the EFF. Welcoming these people into your own political party is killing your own ratings. How? Because these people were not popular. Because these people are average South Africans. So it's killing the ratings. You are looking down on these people. Because these people are average South Africans. So this move, you consider it as ANC killing its own ratings. Man, these people are the people who are voting for the African National Congress. These people that you are calling killing the ratings are the people that have kept the African National Congress on the seat. Average South Africans are the ones who are keeping political parties on the seats. The DA, the EFF, all of these parties are there in parliament because of these people that you are saying they are killing the ratings. So why do you say that the ANC is killing its ratings for working with the people on the ground? Man, you are making, now you are forcing us to defend the African National Congress. I cannot sit here and defend the African National Congress, but you have literally forced me to sit here and defend the African National Congress because of this rhetoric, because of you guys looking down on people making their own decisions. Why can't Afro South Africans make their own decisions? Killing the ratings for working with the people on the ground. Man, each and every day we tell political parties that you guys are not coming to the neighborhoods. We tell political parties that you people are not coming to informal settlements. You are not coming to see how people are living. You are not engaging with the people. You are not starting any programs to improve the lives of the people. And when political parties come to our neighborhoods, when they come to our informal settlements and start working with us, we call it killing the ratings. What is it exactly do these people want? I hate it when I hear someone speaking like this about average South Africans. Man, these are average South Africans. These are our brothers and sisters. You are looking down on average South Africans. You're calling it killing the ratings. Each and every day, when people, every day, they talk about political parties and the fact that they are absent in our neighborhoods. Now they are coming to our neighborhoods, working with the people. Whether you don't like this relationship, whether you don't like what is happening here on your screen, with the ANC and the EFF, man, the ANC and the EFF, as far as I'm concerned, they can have each other. Man, the ANC and the EFF, they deserve each other. They deserve each other. They can have each other. I don't care about them as political parties. But I care about the rhetoric of people looking down on other people because those people made their own decisions. This is what I have a problem with. I don't care about the ANC, man. I'm not going to sit here and defend the ANC. I don't care about the ANC. I'm only defending these people as average South Africans. Average South Africans who can still make their own decisions.
It's such a shame that people are really going to endorse that. Who endorsed that in Lithuli? How do they even agree on an idea of endorsing that while they should be focusing on 100 and something million?
Why do you want to tell the ANC what to focus on? The ANC knows their priorities. Why must you tell the ANC what to focus on? Oh, now, because the EFF supporters are leaving the EFF and joining the ANC, you are telling the ANC not to focus on this thing, to focus on that. You don't want the ANC to acknowledge the fact that the EFF supporters are coming to the ANC. You don't want them to acknowledge that. Man, this is politics. The ANC can walk and chew at the same time. They can deal with the matter of 100 million at the same time while still welcoming the members of the EFF. Why do you want the ANC to turn a blind eye and now look at 100 million and completely ignore the fact that EFF supporters are now coming to join the party? Now you are telling the ANC what to do. You started by telling these people what to do. Now you are telling the ANC what to do. Only because you want to defend the EFF. Man, this is the reason why I told you guys that I will never be the member of any political party. I will never join any political party, man. I will never join any political party. I remember when Action SA started, I joined online, but I cancelled. Because I couldn't stand the thought of being a member of any political party. Because I don't want to defend political parties to this extent. I don't want to be someone out here defending political parties and defending politicians that don't even know me. Politicians, they don't know you. They don't care about you. Julius Malema will never do anything for you. But you are here defending his party, defending his ideas, defending his party all over the place. People didn't even sleep last night, crying all over social media. Telling us, no, it can't be. Those people were bought. It's fake. Those people were bought. It's fake. This is politics, man. Stop caring about political parties so much. Stop caring about politicians so much. I love this platform because, man, on this platform, we don't care about political parties, man. We care about the people of this country. We care about the advancement of people of this country. I don't care about political parties, man. I've said it a long time ago that political parties will never do anything for the people of South Africa, man. Political parties and politicians, they thrive on hate. They thrive on divisions. As long as people in this country are divided, as long as people in this country hate each other, man, political parties, they will always be relevant. The politicians will always be relevant. So now it's up to us as people in this country, especially black people. It's up to us if we don't want to work together, if we don't want to uplift our communities together. I mean, politicians will always be relevant in our lives. It's up to us. If we the people, if we black people in this country don't want to come together and say, guys, this is nonsense. The decisions that we have been making about our own country for the past 30 years, it is a nonsensical decision. And say most of these political parties, man, 80% of these political parties, man, they should be non-existent. There's nothing that these people are doing for the people. Man, you can look at other political parties. What is it exactly that they are doing for the people of this country? Taxpayers are paying for these people to enjoy the most luxurious life in parliament. And these people are doing nothing for the people of South Africa. Man, I've said this a million times, that political parties are not going to do anything for us. This is why I don't care about any political party. I don't care. I don't care. I don't love any political party. I don't love any politician, man. I love South Africa and I love South Africans. This is the kind of person I am and this is the platform that we are in. I will never defend political parties to this extent. I will never defend political parties to this extent. Man, it is shameful. As a man, you need to have your own pride. You need to have your own pride as a man and say, man, I cannot defend another man like this. I cannot defend another man's legacy like this. You are a man at the end of the day, but you are out here. You are out here kissing, washing Julius Malema's feet. Because you want to defend him so much. You can't even bear the thought of seeing average South Africans making their own decisions. Now you are calling it law. The African National Congress went to the people on the ground. Guys, this is the reason why the African National Congress will always win the elections. Because the African National Congress, if there's one thing they understand, is that the people on the ground are the ones who are keeping the African National Congress alive. This is why the African National Congress will always go to the people on the ground. These political parties are doing the podcast. They are doing the conventions there at the Sandton Convention Center. They are inviting celebrities. They are doing all of these things instead of going to the people and talk to the people. This is why the African National Congress will always win the elections. This is why. Because now this thing that is happening right now, you are calling it low. You say African National Congress is killing the ratings. Fikile Mbalula is killing the ratings of the African National Congress. How are you killing the ratings of the African National Congress? By going to the people. These are the people that are keeping the party breathing. These are the people that are voting for the party.
It is such a shameful act, and
people need to stop, man. Man, you can't. We cannot defend politicians to that. I will never defend political parties or politicians to that extent, man. At the end of the day, I'm still a man. I don't care about political parties, man. And I think people in this country, that where we are right now, we have people who are looking at these political parties, who are looking at these politicians as media entities. They are looking at these politicians as celebrities. They are looking at political parties as media entities. They want to be entertained by these people. They don't care about the solutions on the ground. They want to be entertained by these people. They will defend these people so much. Even though that these people are doing what for them, they will defend these people so much. They will defend these people more than they defended South Africa. The EFF right now, they will defend their own party more than they defend South Africa. We are here saying that, guys, the issue of illegal immigrants is killing South Africa. The people in this country, man, they are losing their own children. People are losing their own family members in the hands of illegal immigrants. But now you have people from the EFF telling you, now we must open the borders. Open the borders. Because why? Julius Malema said, open the borders. So we don't care about our own communities. We don't care about what the illegal immigrants are doing in the country. We don't care about that. We simply want to appease politicians. This is what is happening right now in South Africa. And it is, you hear this guy talking about shameful. It is shameful hearing young South Africans defend politicians so much. Man, young South Africans should defend South Africa. We should be like, man, we don't care. Political parties, we can accept your ideology. We can listen to you if you provide the solutions that are going to bring this country forward. It is so sad hearing young people defend the political parties, defend the politicians. We cannot do that, man. We should defend South Africa. We should fight for the future of this country, not the future of political parties.
Focusing on 100 and something million It is such a shameful act, and if they are not called it, if they are not called out for such an act, I don't know. But what needs to be said is that the actions of the ANC by some of their leaders will really affect the ANC in 2024. Forget Ramaphosa, forget Palapala. There are people who continue to speak in public. There are people who continue to voice their opinion, but in turn, they are really discrediting that movement. It is that.
Why are you worried about what is happening in the African National Congress? You say the action of the leaders of the African National Congress is going to cost the African National Congress in 2024. Man, we could say that about all the political parties and their leaders. We could say that by John Steenhuisen, by sitting on his hands while the ANC and the EFF are taking taking the fight from him, his actions are going to cost the DA in 2024. We could say that. We could say that. We could say Floyd Shivambu failing to declare the money that he got from Zgameka, it could hurt the EFF in 2024. We could say that. We could say that about all the members or all the leaders of all political parties. So for you to say this as if it's some kind of a statement, just because you are making it about ANC, it doesn't mean that it sounds smart. It doesn't sound smart. We can say this about all political parties.
Dead donkey. But they are really burying that donkey before even the funeral comes. Now they're speaking about Mavuso Msimang saying that, well, he's probably going to join other parties. He's really betraying the ANC. This guy has been with the ANC for so long. He's showing his disapproval for the actions of the governing party. And by resigning, he's tired of that. For them to go back and do some introspection, they are not going to do that. In turn, they're just throwing insults, accusation at a former veteran.
Man, guys, I think at this point you can hear that the guy is just rambling around. This is the sentiments of the EFF. They are just rambling around. This is what I'm trying to tell you. They are just rambling around. But at the end of the day, these are African South Africans. These are our brothers. These are our sisters. They can make their own decisions. They can make their own decisions. Whether the EFF likes this or doesn't like it, I don't care. I don't like it. I don't like it, man. I don't care about the EFF and the ANC. I don't care about what the EFF and the ANC do to each other. But I'm saying that these people, they can make their own decisions. And the EFF is just rambling around, telling the ANC this, telling the ANC that. Man, the ANC should do this. The ANC shouldn't do that. Man, they are trying to tell the ANC what to do. They started by telling average South Africans what to do. They are now telling political parties what to do. Man, at the end of the day, we can make our own decisions. We are South Africans. At the end of the day, we have our own decisions. We can make our own decisions. No one must be there acting like God because someone made a decision that they don't like. We can make our own decisions as South Africans. And the EFF, man, I would advise the EFF, man, to guys, please be mature a bit. This is politics. This stuff happens. Just because you saw a video of these people being given t-shirt outside of the hall and to enter the hall, it doesn't mean these people were bought. These people were members of the EFF. It doesn't make sense for these people to go and to leave their own houses, to go to the halls wearing the EFF t-shirts only to prove that they were members of the EFF. They don't have to prove that they were the members of the EFF. So it makes sense for these people to wear the EFF t-shirts at the event so that they can go to the stage and take out these t-shirts and wear the ANC t-shirts. This is statements. This is politics. Guys, you need to be mature. Guys, please tell me what you think in the comment section. Don't forget to hit that like button. And the most important part is subscribe. My name is Thomas Mabaso. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.